back. But Reuben, be careful. It's going to fall out here. And we're all on our way. It's a five-star's house. And we reckon that just about now they should be getting breakfast on, because we're all starving and it's a long way from Manchester. And we do hear that Delroy is a dab hand with the old frying pan. Anyway, if you've ever wanted to know how stars spend a Saturday morning, stay tuned.
You don't get mad. You just get evil. It's something I didn't mean to do. You just go in different directions. It happens. It happens to be true. But don't be sad. Don't even get angry. I still believe that we can see it through. Just don't forget everything you give, you get. And in a while, it all comes back to you. You wanna rock my world, 'cause I'm rocking yours. So baby, don't let that guy start making you jealous. He knows by now why I'm not free. And baby, I'll bet my heart when you go out with the fellas that you would do it. Same for me. You wanna rock my world, 'cause I'm rocking yours.
Michael Jackson moves in that video at all. Five star rock my world.
There she goes. They've got electric gates. Oh, I've got at least two of those at home, actually.
Oh.
Are those all the cars?
That's the best you'll ever see Anthea driving.
Yes. Actually, Anthea's driving quite slowly today. I wonder how Dave the cameraman's got up there. He must be perched on the top of the roof or something.
Nice garden, actually. Nice little garden.
Well, hi, Upa.
Hello.
Hello. Car fillers are being dragged to the edge backwards, blown all over the M25. How's the video voting going, the cartoon?
We'll give you an update in just a tick. We're waiting for it to come there frantically.
Oh, look at this. Isn't this absolutely fantastic?
Oh.
Do you know, one day when you grow up, you're going to look like one of these. Right, now then, lads. Derek, Mike, this could be the best breakfast we have ever had in our whole lives. So you're not going to disgrace me or anything like that, are you? Okay? Right. So, come on then. This is it. Breakfast with Five Star. It's like a dream come true, isn't it? Oh, it's got one of those doorbells that goes ding-dong. You can hardly hear it. Hello! Nice to see you.
Hiya.
How are you?
Hi.
Right. Fine, thanks very much. Don't forget to wipe your feet, will you? Right.
Just having breakfast.
Oh, it's really nice. Thanks very, very much. Hey, sorry about Derek, but he's a bit nosy. You don't mind, do you? He's just like having a look around.
I don't like nosy people, but Derek.
Hiya, hello.
Hi.
How's it going? Hiya. Wow, this looks fantastic. Full fry up. I want everything. Everything. Who's had a hand in this? Who's done what?
To eat and don't
want
to
burn
the food.
Where's Stephen gone?
Oh, he's sleeping, isn't he?
Yes, he's sleeping. You're joking.
Yeah.
You haven't got up.
I've got three in my grand place box.
Ah, come on. Oh, you've seen all that. Hey, the kitchen's fantastic.
Thank you.
Was this all in when you arrived?
Yeah.
And the Argud, have you ever used that?
Yep.
I've heard that before. Is it all right if I take my coat off?
Yeah.
Can you have that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Would you like a drink?
Juice? Yeah, what's that?
Pineapple.
Fantastic.
Great.
Oh. Can I sit here?
Yeah, sit anywhere you like.
Great,
how's everything going then? How's your single going?
Really
did you see us play the video?
Yes.
I just can't believe it.
And what about the album? How's it going?
Oh, what do you mean, what about the album?
This album? No, it releases on August the 15th.
Yeah?
So we're really looking forward
it's
to
it. Fabulous.
Yeah, it's really good inside.
Yeah. Stedman?
Can you see me there?
Can we just go and have a look at what Stedman is cooking? Because I want to know... Sorry, Delroy, I want to know exactly what I'm eating.
What are you eating? I'm eating bacon first.
Yeah?
Is that
looks
like
so much grease in there.
Does that look like bacon?
Don't worry about that.
Don't worry about the grease. Are you sure? I'm a bit worried about my cholesterol levels at the moment. You're a bit steamed up, just hold on a second.
See it.
Can you see better now? Right. Okay then. Right, I'll have about three of those if you don't
really?
Mind. And I want my eggs sunny side up.
Okay.
Can we have cereal?
Pardon?
Can we have cereal?
No, I won't have any cornflakes. I want to go straight for it.
Tea? Coffee?
What about you, Tony, Jenny?
How very health conscious.
Can all you lot hear us?
Yeah, we can hear you perfectly.
I hate to say this, I'm dead excited, you see, but did you ever see me do my impression of you?
No.
Oh, good, I won't do it then. Listen, you're quite healthy eaters, aren't you?
That's right.
Yeah. I mean, we've spotted loads of bowls of fruit. Have you only put that out for today?
That's right.
It's also the first kitchen table I've ever seen a record on. Is that by coincidence? You don't have an LP coming out, do you, by any chance?
We've had the television on all morning. We've been watching.
There
it's been
is.
Great. Oh, Stedman. Yeah. Stedman's woken up now.
Oh, my goodness.
Stedman. Finally come down. Open your eyes, Stedman.
Do they like cricket? Anthea, can you ask them if they like cricket?
Do you like cricket?
Yeah.
Oh, good.
Yes, we do like cricket.
We're going to go across to the Oval cricket. Now. That's why we're hopefully Simon Parkin. Anthea, ask the boys if they play cricket, or the girls.
Well, who plays cricket?
Me.
Oh, I played cricket recently. I used to
like
to
play when you were at school?
Sorry?
Did you play when you were at school?
Yeah, a lot.
So, I've got to tell you, there were three cats in the kitchen. They've just gone scuttling out.
Oh, yeah.
I can hear the fried egg actually coming through. Anthea, can you also ask them, they're pretty close to their fans, aren't they?
Pardon?
How close are they to their fans?
Well, intimately, so I hear.
Yeah,
you're
very close to
them.
Just
look
close
there.
Here, Tony's
so
here.
Close.
Derek. Sorry.
Yeah, we are really close to our
friends, actually.
We've always got
it.
They answer all their letters.
Was that who? Do they get people outside those big gates sort of every morning like we saw today?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Do you?
A lot of people
mostly
outside the gates.
On the weekends, though, when they've all got time to come down. It's really nice, though.
The smell in this kitchen is absolutely fantastic.
I don't know.
Can you believe it?
I don't wait for them.
They're having such a party.
I think we'll leave the party. Listen, we have a very. We did something today. This is a mega, mega surprise for somebody. They didn't know all about this. Watch this, and just watch the excitement and the surprise on their face. Watch this. Mega.
Three years, and I've been a member of the fan club for about a year.
Can I ask you a dead personal question? Do you dance like Five Star?
No.
No, funny that, I can't dance either. Now, listen, I'm glad you're sitting down, because we've got some really bad news for you. You know how we thought that you were going to be able to talk by the magic of TV to Five Star?
Yeah.
Well, unfortunately, something to do with baked bean tins and string, we haven't actually got all the technical bits sorted out. So, got a bit of a surprise for you instead. Come and have a look over here. Come on, quick. And you, Mum, come on. Have a look down here. You see this chap here with the hat on? He's a chauffeur, and that's his dead posh car that he's chauffeuring. Who do you think that car is for?
You.
No, not for me, because it's actually for you, because that car is going to rush you to Five Star's house, where you're going to go and meet them. So go on, quick, let's run down, quick. Not got much time. Got to be there soon, so trundle into the car, quick. Run to the car, and you go as well, Mum. Brilliant. It's all so exciting, isn't it? There they go, into the car. Bundle of nerves. And not even a Five Star dance on the way as well. Chauffeur-driven car. Even I don't get that. So they're off to Sunningdale, of course. It's going to take them a while to get there. So hopefully, doing the speed limit, but hopefully we'll get there on time. And she'll be talking to Five Star later. There they go. Give them a quick wave as they go. Oh, it's not fair. I wanted to go for breakfast with Five Star. Ooh.
To Has anybody been near Lyme Park, you lot?
No, probably near it without knowing, but no, not really.
Oh.
We're playing some live gigs at Manchester, at the Apollo.
That's it, that's very near to Lyme Park.
Yeah.
What about you, because you're going on a European tour, aren't you, soon?
Mm-hmm.
Whereabouts are you going to be going to?
We'll be going to Germany and
Norway.
Spain, Norway.
Yes.
Sweden. Mm. You're looking forward to it?
Brilliant, yeah.
What about America? Because will you be going on your world tour and visiting America?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You're not by any chance going to Florida?
Florida.
No.
Hopefully, yes.
No?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, you can have a look at Florida and soften up your dad.
What, 10? Yeah, oh, she was 10. No, she was 10 and I was 11 when we decided that we wanted to be in a group, but our dad said that we were too young, so we waited until we left school because they wanted us to finish our education.
So when did you start playing your own instruments and writing your own music?
Well,
we all used to do guitar lessons at school at 16.
Yeah. I don't know what you did. I took the paper to music when I was in the infant school. I used to play recorder.
Uh-huh.
I was about 4 or 5. Mm-hmm. And my dad was really surprised when he heard me play, you know, so they put me to the headmistress and I had to play it in front of her, you know. It was a bit of a struggle, you know, but it was...
Oh, what about you, Delroy? What about you?
Well, I play keyboards, drums, and guitars. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like to mess about with all that sort of thing. Meanwhile, while we're on the subject of talking, let's go over to the studio.
Okay, then come on, right? Oh. Are we all here?
Come on.
Thanks very much. Can we go through? Sorry about this, Derek. Derek's having to walk backwards now.
I know.
You don't mind about this, do you?
Well, don't worry.
Mickey's there.
Derek's a genius.
The house is... I mean, it's absolutely beautiful. How long have you lived here?
We've lived here just over a year and a half.
Yes.
You must have been bursting out of your place in Sunningdale, Ascot. No, where was it? Romford.
Romford.
That was it.
Yes.
That's why you used to be so fat then. That's why we were bursting out of the house. It's all right now.
Where do we go through? Go past here? Yeah, down here. Well, now, this is the car that I think Thomas would really like when he becomes a famous rock star. But it's not pink, but it's very nice. You know when we see and we read all about the... Oh, the newspaper cuttings, and they all say that everybody owns a different car, but everybody seems to get it wrong. Can you just put the record right? Who owns which car?
The black Lamborghini at the end belongs to Denise. As you can see, Denise got into her car.
But I know Denise hasn't passed the test yet, has she?
That's right, but she'll pass that soon, no worries about that. The white one is the best, that's mine.
Yeah.
That belongs to,
How
to
fast
me.
Do they go?
These can do about over 190, they'll do. This Mercedes Sports belongs to Doris, which you can't get open at the moment. This is very embarrassed. The red Ferrari belongs to Lorraine.
Yes.
The red Mercedes belongs to Stead.
And what about this one here, this whacking great thing?
This thing is the family car.
So is it the only one that everybody could get inside?
Yes.
It's amazing. Hello? Hello? You have to drive this?
I ain't clean it.
I could do with him over at my house.
A pink Rolls
Derek, just have a look inside there. Wow.
He's got a TV.
So you drive it and you drive along watching the television?
Videos.
Oh, this is just amazing. This is just out of this world. Oh, is this your studio?
This is the studio, yeah.
Oh, in the garage.
In the garage. Have a seat.
Great. How does it all work?
Okay. Right, basically, we have a 16-track mixer here. 16-track recorder. And basically what we do is, it all starts here with the drums.
Mm-hmm.
Get everything down. And then we start doing bass and things on the keyboards. And then you overdub on percussion, which also comes from here. And it all just builds up.
And is it only you who works in here?
Denise does a little bit in here. But there's so much new gear around all
the
time.
Can they come in without your permission?
Without my permission, yeah, but they won't get very far, isn't it?
Now, I know that you've got your own record label as well, haven't you?
Right,
Tenge
yeah.
Records.
Yeah.
Do other artists come and use a studio?
Not at the moment. Later on this year, we are planning to build a bigger studio, a major studio.
Oh, what other artists have you got?
We have voice is broken, you see. I haven't got over that stage. We have a new group called The Jewel, which is a twin act. Tim
Brilliant.
And Keith,
yeah,
Attack. Yes, they're great. And, we signed them recently.
And apparently, in fact, we can see it now. There we go, we've got The Jewel on. Mm. They're great, we're really proud.
You know what they tell you?
Weren't those two
guys, I've recognised them from somewhere. Weren't they in a group in the 70s?
Yes, they were. Which is called...
Child.
Child, that's right.
That's it. I thought I remembered them. And I think one of them toured with David Cassidy because I remember seeing them there. This is absolutely amazing. There's another studio you've got, isn't it? That's the dance studio.
Right.
Can we go through to there?
Let's go and have a look.
Oh, okay, it's so nosy now. Sorry about that. Bye-bye. Whereabouts?
Doris, through there.
Through here? Hi, Doris.
Would you like to come and take the dance lessons?
Well, I don't know if I could take any lessons. I don't think I'm good enough. But I'd love to see your studio.
And we've lost Mr. Cameraman. See him running.
No, he's right here. Derek's never very far behind, are you, Derek? This is a great room.
Yeah.
Do you have parties in here?
Yeah, we have guests. We all talk and laugh.
Oh, that's really nice. Beautiful. Did you do all the interior designing yourself?
Some of it. This was all designed.
Wow. A lot. Now, this is where Derek really comes into his own, isn't he? Derek, Dave the cameraman, Mickey the mic.
First of all, I just stand here, I play the music, and then I think, and I just do any stupid little move, and then if it looks good, I just rewind the tape, play it again, then I'm on the floor.
And how do you go about telling all the others what they've got to do?
Well, I just line them all up and show them what to do step by step.
But what if somebody said to you, I'm sorry, I don't really like that?
No, Lorraine always says that. Lorraine's the one that always says, I can't do that, Doris. But I know she can.
So what do you say to her?
I say, I know you can do it. So even if she does look silly, with a little practice.
Who's the one who takes the longest to learn a dance step?
No, nobody takes the longest, really. I mean, with forgetting the routines, it's funny, I always do.
Have you ever been on the stage and one of you's gone, I can't remember what to do next?
No, probably in rehearsal. But we... just joke around and improvise.
Improvise.
Yeah, that's
well, it's a fabulous place to be, but I tell you what, being in here makes me feel sort of exhausted. Oh, can we go out into the garden? It's a lovely day. I want a bit of peace and quiet out in the garden. Your fingers on the phones. Which ones are you going to be voting for?
John Barnham.
We've got a telephone here, so we'll be ringing up in a moment. Yeah. This has got to be like every girl's dream, to be in a makeup room like this. All the lights, all the makeup scattered around here. Denise, who knows just about everything there is to know about makeup.
So do I.
And Lorraine, who's learnt everything she knows off Denise.
Thanks.
Denise, I think it would be fair to say that of your two beautiful sisters as well, that it's you who's always had the very dramatic makeup.
Yeah,
when did you first decide to do that?
Since the beginning, actually, with these points, when I had my makeup and the points.
This is a really old photograph, isn't it? When was that taken?
Yeah, that was taken... quite a few years ago, actually, a couple of years ago.
You've all changed such a lot.
And, I really wanted to do the points because I thought it would make my eyes look a bit bigger, but it didn't.
It's become
a nice style, and I will wear it sometimes, and sometimes kind of lose it.
So where do you get all your ideas from? Do you copy them out of magazines?
I don't copy them. I just look at magazines or get my ideas. I just think of how I want to look, so I just...
Do you do each other's makeup?
No, never. Really. No.
Never.
Lorraine does her own, as you can see. And Doris does hers. This is Doris.
Yeah.
Doris off the makeup.
No, but now it's got more simple with the without the points.
And you can see.
And up to so that. What sort of makeup do you use?
It's a theatrical makeup. It'll kind of like stay on while we do performances on stage.
Because when you sweat so much, your makeup can wash off.
Yeah.
With you having to wear so much makeup, do you all get spots?
No, we don't wear so much. Sometimes we wear makeup that doesn't agree with us. You know, when you're trying that.
I don't. Right. Now, what about... Hello? Do you mind?
I'm sorry.
We were these girls talking about makeup.
Really? Well, there's another side to it.
All right.
Yeah, about the costumes.
Great. We're going to go and have a look at the clothes and the costumes now. So, come on, Derek. Come on. What's in here? What's in there?
Oh, that's just the steam room.
Is that where if you do get your spots, you can get rid of them?
That's the way. Thanks. Oh, well. Here we go.
Oh, wow. These are amazing.
These ones we used on tour. The black.
Now,
are these
latest costumes?
No, these are last year's.
So, do you do all the styling for the group?
most of the styling, most of the costume styling, but now everybody takes part now, which that way we, you know, we sort of like get
so, the new so style. Where do you get all your ideas from for all this?
Most of my inspiration comes from like Doris's choreography.
Yeah.
And the way the girls make their costumes, like the makeups and
these are
like
great though. Let's just go and have a look inside these wardrobes a little bit.
Yeah.
Come on.
This was on our very, very first tour.
Derek, get round here. Look at these. These are amazing. What happens to all the costumes when you don't want to use them anymore?
Well, they're always put away safely in a cool place. So uh-huh. That way they stay good. Hey,
what about all the clothes?
One.
What about
look at this one.
This was when our dressmaker thought we were midgets. Honestly, can you believe that?
Hmm? Are these... How old were you when you wore these?
I was 19.
We didn't wear that.
No, you can wear it.
Well, I know Kylie Minogue is in the studio, and she's a very stylish young lady.
We hear now that Keely O'Dowd is actually arriving. She left London quite a while ago. I think she's been stuck in quite a bit of traffic. But they have got here, I know it's a BBC car, very posh one. Keely has got her mum with her. Her name's Valerie. And they're just coming through those gates now, the electric gate. She's coming down. Oh, gosh, it's a DG's car. Just look at that. She's here with the Up To You stickers on the front, BBC television. And, oh, just look at her face. Hello, Keely. Hello. BBC chauffeur looks very smart, doesn't he? Like the shades. It's the new image. Hello. Now then. You're going to take through to the fan club office. Through to the fan club office.
Okay, come this way.
Come on, hello.
Hello.
Hi, nice to meet you.
You too.
She's so happy. And by the way, if you're wondering what all these rosettes and things are, it's actually the Lorraine's 21st birthday and they're having the party tomorrow, all in the grounds, and it's going to be a real posh do. This, by the way, is Tent Records. We're going through the reception here. Just have a look at all the discs that are on the walls and everything.
And the albums, too.
Of course. Just put it away. We get that with Kellogg's. Keely. Now, look, everybody here, this is the fan club office. And when you send your letters in to the fan club, this is where they all come. Don't you think it's amazing?
Yes.
Now then, we've got a lady over there, her name is Debbie, and she's going to tell us what happens when your letter arrives at the fan club office. Right. Debbie.
Well, Keely, we have the letters, and we see what the fans want, and then we deal with them in the same day. Their packets get sent out, or they have their merchandise, or if they need to meet Five Star, we find letters to send out to them.
So there you go. And of course, you do read all the letters,
yes,
don't you?
Yes, we can. Personalise them.
And how do you decide what you're going to put up on the walls?
Well, my mum does most of this. Yeah. And
along with the fan club.
Yeah, Julie
workers.
And Debbie. Mm-hmm.
So what do you think about it all?
It's excellent. It's great.
And are you a lifelong fan now?
Yes.
Is that a present?
Thank you.
Are you going to get them to sign it?
Definitely.
Yeah. And what are you going to say to your friends when you get home?
Great, I was so surprised.
Go on, Jenny and Tony.
We're saying
goodbye. Yes, we're going. Look, I've got a Polaroid for next week's opening titles.
Oh, great.
Picture of Keely. Listen, we've had a fantastic time here. It wasn't just the breakfast, but being able to put it away, Jenny. But being able to see around the house. And of course, we must thank Mr. and Mrs. Pearson for letting us do all this.
And here, can I quickly say the phone lines are open for the disco dancing until 1 o'clock?
I can't just hear you.
All right.
That's all right, carry on.
What did you say? Say that again.
I just want to say the phone lines are open for the disco dancing voting until 1 o'clock.
Well, we've been doing some disco dancing here.
And also, Kylie says goodbye to Five Star.
Sorry, I'm not hearing you.
Kylie says goodbye to Five Star.
Oh, goodbye. Good. Kylie says goodbye to you.
Bye, Kylie. Bye.
Rest of my life, together we can love forever. Are we just playing too shy to let it show?
Let it show.
Around the back door, the snow is falling. It paints a picture just to let us know that now's the right time to get together to make. The night we met.